Hello, Dr. James Bogash, expert in health and longevity, and today we're going to get you yet another tip to lower your risk of cardiovascular disease, which, despite everything, still remains the number one killer, always has been, always will be, and it's hugely preventable. Despite that, it's preventable with lifestyle, not with modern medicine, otherwise it wouldn't still be the number one killer. Statins have just a really small impact on cardiovascular disease. Otherwise, because we give them to everybody, cardiovascular disease wouldn't exist or would be drastically lower. Instead, it remains the number one killer. So every little thing you can do to lower your risk of cardiovascular disease is incredibly important, and diet plays a massive role in this. I've talked about the Life's Essential 8 multiple times before with the American Heart Association's, and great recommendations. The dietary recommendations and the exercise could be a little bit more specific, and when you start getting into the nitty-gritty, there are aspects of our diet that are more protective than others. And in this particular study, the authors, it was out of China, looking at a little over 26,000 people and how spicy foods at least once a week had an impact on their risk of cardiovascular disease. The sad thing is that 17,000 people in this study never ate spicy foods. Like, kind of a boring palate, I guess. But certainly we all know people who, the second you introduce any pepper or salt or anything, it's already too much for them. But the wasn't a drastic reduction, but they followed these people over 8.5 years, and they found that those who had spicy foods at least once a week had about a 6% lower risk of major cardiac events. So that's things like cardiac death, heart attacks, stroke, those kind of things. Not a bad thing. Just add a couple jalapenos once a week and you just dropped your risk of heart disease that much more. Why this may have to do with capsaicin. Capsaicin is a component of a lot of spicy foods. We also know that spicy foods and capsaicin in particular increases the amount of brown fat that we have, which is exactly what we want. We want more brown fat, which burns calories just for heat. And it's kind of like the Holy Grail. We've looked to researchers and look for ways to increase brown fat from a drug standpoint. We already know natural things like cold exposure, short-term cold exposure, not long-term cold exposure, because the body adapts. And things like spicy foods can actually increase the amount of brown fat you have, leading to more, we're burning more calories, so less obesity, less overweightness, and that probably might be the reason why it lowers the risk of cardiovascular disease, even just once per week. As always, I'll post a link to this particular study in the description. Make sure you like this video, share it with somebody who you think needs the information, and subscribe to the channel.